In the previous lesson or in the previous module, we have also seen about the little bit about the password spraying attacks, that how it actually works. And we have also used the confirming success rate using the BUP suite. In this lesson, we are going to use the password spraying attacks with the help of BUP suite that makes the password spraying easier and the account lockout will not be occurred at the same time. So that is the benefit of using the password spraying attack. Let's see password spraying attack in action. So for that, I have a target here. So we need to create the usernames list, multiple usernames list. So I'm going to register by using the password, simple password like the test, so that we will create it quickly, because this site deletes it at the same speed. So the registration process will be for every name here. I've already tested it, because this deletes the every username. This is automated system, so it deletes all. So I hope this all four users are there. Now I'm going to test the login function here. So if this is going to login or not. Alright, so it is logged in. I am going to capture one login request here by going to this one. So the first one, and I'm going to put something else, you know, to not let it log in. And the password will be same, that is the test. Intercept is on. Login. It is intercepted. Send it to intruder and then make it off. Going to intruder, we can have the same site with the positions. By going to target site, we can see this is saying invalid logins. We need to do every actions in faster way for this site only. Otherwise, for the real targets, we doesn't know that the site is going to delete or not. Or in many cases, it is not going to delete anything. So this is for just the testing. Alright, so I'm going to use the clear function here, clear, and placing the payload at only one place. So in that case, what will happen is that the only username will be iterated by the list of the usernames, and the password will not be changing. So the password remains the same. Only the usernames are iterated on the target side. The attack type will be a sniper. This is perfect for this kind of attacks. Going to payload, we will have the simple list. I need to put everything. This one. And so on. So putting some other name. Now let's start the attack and see everything in action. As you can see, this is starting with the first one, that is the 302 status is not, and we can see the number 2, number 3, number 4, and number 5 is with the status code 200 with the different length and the length size of that packets. So we can see this is the test. Going to response and the render tab, we can see this is saying the logout with the name. We can be sure that the name is misplaced here. This is because of the target site is actually handling it that way. So this is not the matter of the name here or the username here. We are only having the information about the target is deleting each usernames once it is going to have something, some frequency or the time set by the target site. But this way, We can be sure the target is accepting all of the details. Like we can see here, this is logged in by the this name, having the 200 status, and this is the mic. But this is wrong also in that case. But what we are actually conducting in this case is the username is iterating on the target site, but the password is remaining the same. What happens in most of the cases or the secured site is whenever you put the password for a single username multiple times, the account will understand that we are using the brute force or dictionary attack. In that case, the account will be locked out. But in this case, we are not attacking a single user. We are attacking a single password for the list of user. So what will happen in this case? We are testing one user with the one attempt. That is what we say password spraying attacks. So we are spraying the passwords on the multiple users. The same passwords, that is the test, we can be sure from every link here. The password is same for every username. Only the username is changing. So that way there will be no fear of account lockout threshold reached, and even there will be no any actions found on the target site. So this is the way, and the best part of this is the account lockout will not occur, and in that case the success rate for this kind of attack is around 5 to 10%, because a single password, we can be sure from the already compromised passwords from the databases, we can understand that password patterns, that what are the mostly used passwords of the year, and then use that same password to iterate through all of the usernames on the target site. There are the chances of the one user or two user or 10 user maybe or might have the same password that we are spraying over all of the users' account. You can try out password spraying attacks in a number of different ways by using number of different tools as well. There are multiple tools to use the password spraying attacks, and basically this is the technique to use the password spraying attack. Every tool for the attacking the passwords and the web-based attacks can be used to the password spraying attacks, and leveraging the technique will attempt to uncover the usernames, and the same passwords will be sprayed over multiple users or the usernames accounts. Hope you understand about the password spraying attack from this lesson. You can try it out, test it on the number of different sites or the number of dummy sites available over the internet. You can also try out using the real sites as well. See you in the next lessons. Thank you.